But today I'm going to show you how to write in Braille using a standard QWERTY keyboard and a free program called Perky Duck. First thing to do is to go to DuxburySystems.com on the left-hand side, navigate halfway down the list to all products, and then scroll down to the bottom of the page to where it says Perky Duck, free computer-based emulator of the Perkins Brailler, and click on the link Perky Duck Download Windows or Mac. This takes us to a new page, and there's a link for download of Perky Duck for Windows and download of Perky Duck for Mac. I'm going to click on the one for Windows. Once it's done downloading, just go ahead and install it. The pop-up on the screen will tell you what to do. Basically, just keep hitting next, agree to the user agreement, hit next, and then it'll install on the computer. So that Perky Duck is installed on the computer, go back to the desktop, click on Start, and type in the search box Perky Duck. Before we click on the actual app, right-click on it, and click on Pin to Taskbar. That way it'll show up along the bottom on the taskbar, so it's easy for us to find. Now we'll click to open program, that the program opened, and if we try to type using our keyboard, nothing happens. That's because we need to open a new document. You can hit Control-N, or go to File, and click on New. And now we can type. This is me just randomly hitting keys. Now let me explain to you how to actually type what you want. So before you can type Braille on a computer, you need to understand how Braille works. And these six cans of cat food are going to teach us the basics. So Braille is written in a combination of six dots, just like this cat food. It's arranged in two columns of three cans. The first column, starting from top to bottom, we have dots 1, 2, and 3. In the right column, we have dots 4, 5, and 6. So every single number, letter, and punctuation can be written using a combination of six dots. But we need to rearrange these cans so that we can type on a QWERTY keyboard. So I move the cans so they're in one horizontal row. The left hand is going to type the dots 1, 2, and 3, and then the right hand will type dots 4, 5, and 6. Now let me show you on a Perkins Brailler what that looks like. This is a video of my Perkins Brailler. It's a Braille typewriter. You feed paper into it. I turn the knobs. I have a video that explains all the steps if you want to watch that. And then you create the Braille, pushing the keys simultaneously in different patterns. The left hand types dots 1, 2, 3, and the right hand types dots 4, 5, 6. So when you zoom in on the Braille, we have the Braille cell, and each of those dots, remember, have a number, and those correspond to the keys. So if you wanted to write an L, you push dots, or the keys, 1, 2, 3, simultaneously to create an L. So let's switch back over to Perky Duck, and let me show you how that works on a QWERTY keyboard. Showing you a close-up of my QWERTY keyboard, I put labels on top of some of the letters to designate the Braille dots of the cell. For F, I put the number 1, D, number 2, S, dot 3, J is 4, K is 5, L is 6. So if you wanted to type a full cell on the computer screen, you push all six of these keys at the same time. If you wanted to type an A, A is dot 1, you would push the F button, and that creates a dot 1. So I recommend going through and typing all of the dots of the Braille cell one by one. So we have dot 1, dot 2, dot 3, dot 4, dot 5, dot 6. If we want a space, we push the space bar. If you want to go to the next line, you push enter. You can push backspace to go back one space. That's all this program does. It does not copy and paste. It does not transcribe Braille. It's an emulator of a Perkins Brailler.
We're back in Perky Duck. Let's practice writing. Dot 1 is the letter F. D is dot 2. S is dot 3. J is dot 4. K is dot 5. L is dot 6. So practice writing the dot numbers in order to get familiar with which keys you hit to make the dots. Go to the next line by hitting enter. Practice writing the full cell. So put your fingers on the home row and push all six Braille dots at the same time. So, and hit space. We can push the back space to go back one. Push enter. Now let's practice writing the alphabet. We're going to simultaneously push the Braille dots in whatever pattern we want. So dot 1 is A. We want to write the letter B. It's dots 1, 2. C is 1, 4. I'm just going to keep going through. And then if we wanted to write numbers, we need to write the numeric indicator. So that's 3, 4, 5, 6. Now if we type the dot 1, that means number 1. If we did numeric indicator 1, 1, that's 11. And so on. The one last thing I wanted to show you, go back to DuxburySystems.com on the left-hand side. A little over halfway down the list, click on Braille. Go to the second header, it's called UEB Braille Chart and Tactiles, and click on the first link called UEB Braille Chart Available for Download. This is going to be a reference sheet for writing in Braille. Scroll down to the bottom, it says UEB Braille Chart. I want you to check the box. The text next to it says, I understand the Braille chart does not show when to use contractions. Check the box and click on this text. So I'm checking the box and I'm clicking on those words I just read. This makes some more text pop up at the bottom. The screen says, pick one to indicate your interest in obtaining a Braille chart. I'm going to click on, I'm studying to be a special education teacher. On the screen, we have the Duxbury reference chart. We have the alphabet in the top left. The numbers are above the first 9 letters of the alphabet. A stands for the number 1, B stands for 2, but you have to use the numeric indicator before that. Let me show you where that's at. They call it the number sign. It's on the right-hand side underneath punctuation signs, and it looks like a backwards uppercase letter L. They organize their chart alphabetically. They have punctuation, and they have ways of indicating bold, italics, underline. And there's a lot more to it than this, so I'll explain in more detail in another video how to actually use this reference chart.